everyone, welcome back to the Nordcast. Today we will talk about UFC Fight Night 157, which takes place on 31st of September. It's a Saturday for some people. It will be really, really early for European people mostly. For Americans, it will be way earlier in the morning or whatsoever. Please go check it on your own in the UFC official website. So, what takes place in this one for the championship fight in the main event? It's a strawweight division of with the women's. And Jessica Drash is taking on Weili Zhang. A big fight, two strong women, good strikers. Drash is a very explosive striker in the most part. However, Weili Zhang is more of a technical type of striker. And on their last fight, Jessica Andrade took on Rose Namajunas, which in the first round, the fight took place in May, if I'm not mistaken. In the first round, Rose Namajunas was completely outstriking Jessica Andrade. Like, there was no space. It was jab after jab. Then it was a cross jab, cross jab, cross. The footwork of Namajunas is on another level. He's striking so as well. Just imagine that she took out Joanna, which is what we knew as the best before Rose. And Andrade tried slam here a couple of times in the first round. However, Namajunas was always trying to take her arm, lock it for an armbar on the way down or Kimura lock. It never really happened. So second round start, same thing. Namajunas had Jessica easily at that point by striking, then Andrade picked up Rose again. Slams here on the ground in such an uncomfortable position that Namajunas was, because she was trying to put her in a Kimura lock on the way down. So Andrade slams her onto her head. Her neck bends in a very bad way for a human structure. And she just got KO'd by that. So Rose got knocked out. Jessica Andrade picked the championship. It was well done by Jessica. She used her strong tools to win the fight, and she did so. On the other hand, Weili Zhang faced Tessia Torres back in March, the start of March. I'm not quite sure. I'm sorry about that. Weili Zhang pretty much threw double the significant strikes, double the total strikes. She pretty much dominated Tessia in my eyes, got two of the eight takedowns she attempted. Tessia had none. It was a pretty easy fight. Went on unanimous decision for Weili Zhang, unanimous for a reason, of course. I didn't see Tessia managing to do anything in that fight. Of course, she landed some, but she was pretty much not convincingly good enough to beat Weili. Now, Weili facing Andrade is both strong. I explained at the start what I feel about it, and maybe Jessica, surely she said in the interview, I always train different takedowns, so when I go for the takedown, they don't really know which type of takedown I'm going for. Therefore, it's more easy for me to put them down. But Weili is very strong. She's a very good, strong woman. They both are on a fitness level that we might never seen before on strawweight. And yeah, how I think this fight goes, I think we might see decision or knockout for decision, but I'm not sure for who. Andrade might knock out Weili Zhang. I'm more on Andrade's side to win this one, and I'm not quite sure how this goes. Anyway, we'll find out soon. Make sure to tune in. And if Andrade wins this one, she's clearly gonna fight Michelle Watterson, Joanna Jędrzejczyk winner. If Weili Zhang wins, the same, the loser takes the loser of the other fight, and then we have this back and forth cycle on who's fighting for the title. So yeah, All right, guys. Before I close the show, I would like to announce the 7th of September, Khabib versus Dustin Poirier, which is UFC 242. Make sure to do not miss out that one. It's a huge fight for multiple reasons. It's in Abu Dhabi. They have all the Khabib's teammates in it, except one who got his brother who got injured, and he's fighting in the next card, if I'm not mistaken. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and see you later.